and welcome to St. Peter the Apostle Catholic Church and this Mass celebrating the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday. Out of reverence and a courtesy to your neighbor, please remember to silence your cell phones. Our celebrant this morning is Father Vernon Hughley. Our deacon is John Cooper. Please stand and join together in singing number 447, Blessed Be the Lord, number 447.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning once again, and welcome to all of you.
Good morning, Father.
We'd like to welcome Father Joel Martin, who is from St. Bernard's in Coleman. I say this is St. Bernard's weekend and Blooming Festival weekend. So Father Joel is preaching all the masses this weekend, but I told him, let me preside at this mass and he can come and preach, and then he can exit after he finished preaching. Y'all, you don't know what it's like to preside and preach at six masses, but it works on you. And I try to tell my deacons not to do that, but you know, they're super strong, older than me. But he's going to preach and he's going to lead. We want to welcome back Dr. Anthony Patton, who's one of your former musicians here. I said to him, what Ohio wind blew you into St. Peter's? But where there's music, he will follow. Glad to have him back here and with his favorite, Sophie, and
Kevin.
A computer glitch, okay? Just a computer glitch. So this is the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday, Resurrection Power. I like to say that during the Easter season because so much has happened in the scriptures after Jesus rose from the dead. So if I were to ask you, have you experienced, have you witnessed, have you heard resurrection power this last week? I hope all of you could say yes. In today's gospel, Jesus shows up and he offers the gift of peace three times. Be aware of this. Whenever Jesus shows up, things happen and things change. It's the same way in our lives when we pray and we invite him into our lives. a transformation takes place. We know the rest of the story. We done heard about Easter. We done experienced Easter. But do we continue to allow Easter to lift us up, to send us forth? Again, think of that song, "Because He Lives, I Can Face Tomorrow." Think of what I said to you last Sunday. Because of Easter, we have great hope. And Easter gives us resurrection power. So I'm going to challenge you and say to you, you need to be aware of resurrection power the next 40 days. Because see, we shouldn't stay right here. We should rise. So as we gather here today, we gather to give thanks to God for His many graces and blessings. We gather to thank God for Jesus, for who He is, for what He does in our lives, and for the hope and peace that He bestows. So we turn to Him as we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast, kindle the faith of the people you have made your own. Increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of bread and to the prayers. Awe came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exaltation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he
was hard-pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he
stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love is
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in His great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by the power of God are safeguarded through faith, to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now for a little while you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold, that is perishable even though tested by fire, may prove to be for the praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen Him, you love Him. Even though you do not see Him now, yet believe in Him, you rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who have not seen me, but still believe.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When He had said this, He showed them His hands and His side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when He had said this, He breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to Him, "We have seen the Lord." But He said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in His hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into His side, I will not believe." Now a week later, His disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning to you. And many thanks to Father Vernon and to all of you for welcoming St. Bernard Abbey here today. The monastery, as many of you know, at Cullman, Alabama, just an hour north of here. Benedictine monks we are. And getting to come to St. Peter's is quite a treat. They're very jealous of me back at home. And one thing I need to say right away is whenever the monks show up these days, we bring monk's bread with us. Well, next weekend is the Blumen Festival, and I'll say something about that, where they're stockpiling all of the bread and wouldn't let me bring a bit. They haven't done that for the last month, and it has almost caused a riot in some parishes. So thank you for being gentle with me today. Actually, Father Vernon and I go way back. We were at the same seminary for several years, and so I had to get a loaf for him. So when nobody was looking, I sort of felt guilty, but not really. But I brought a loaf for Father Vernon. Don't tell anybody at the monastery that. And maybe for $1,000 donation, he might let go of that loaf of bread. Well, I'll invite you to St. Bernard, but it's good for us to look at this holy word of God. And especially on this wonderful Sunday, Father Vernon mentioned, of course, it's the second Sunday of Easter. It's Divine Mercy Sunday since the year 2000, and Pope St. John Paul II. Goes by a number of other names, more names for this Sunday than any other Sunday in the church year. It's called White Sunday in some places because the newly baptized at Easter wore white garments all throughout the week. And finally, on the eighth day of the Easter octave, that's today, they were able to remove those white vestments that they wore in remembrance of their baptism and the difference that that made in their life. It's also called, of course, St. Thomas Sunday by many people because of St. Thomas and his doubting. He gets a bum rap, though, I think, and it's good to look at that for a minute, which I'll do. It's also called, interestingly enough, Quasimodo Sunday. You probably think of Quasimodo as the hunchback of Notre Dame in Paris. That was the name given to that misshapen little baby left in Notre Dame Cathedral by his mother, who just could not handle taking care of this little baby. And so she left it in Notre Dame for the priests there to find. They figured he'd be taken care of in that way. So they found him, and they named him Quasimodo because today, and it used to be known this throughout the world, today is Quasimodo Sunday. The first word in the Gregorian chant introit, which they're singing at St. Bernard today, as usual, is Quasimodo, and it just means like. Like newborn babes, thirsting for the mother's milk, we thirst for God. From St. Paul. So happy Quasimodo Sunday, too. You can look that up and see the ins and outs of that great name. Well, it's such an amazing time for us, and of course, Easter is too big. It's the event of our life as Christians who follow the Lord, because it changes everything. In this festival of Easter, the Lord laughs at death, which is something that we all have to taste on this earth, loved ones who go before us. The death of just being ill and the death of suffering that we all must endure sooner or later. And our Lord tells the rest of the story. You see here, I noticed at the last Mass at 7 o'clock this morning, we see as Catholics the image of the crucified Savior always. That's how we know God's love, that God, who made everything and holds us in existence, would die for us, and he did. And you see that in the crucifix that was brought in the procession this morning. You see it in that window. You see the cross there with a crown of thorns. You see that suffering and death. But looming over everything is the risen and ascended Lord. That's the rest of the story. And that's what we get to celebrate today. Not just Easter Sunday, but Easter Sunday plus a week of weeks. A week of weeks, you can count it, 7 times 7, 49. 49 plus Easter Sunday, 50. On the 50th day, we celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit, Pentecost. The 40th day, we celebrate that ascension of the Lord into heaven. These are wonderful times. So we get to say Happy Easter for quite a few days, 50 all told. Don't hesitate to do it and to remember what this day is to us, this great celebration of 50 days. But today, very powerful day, because we're celebrating, as you know, 2 days. That day of the resurrection of the Lord, but we celebrate also a week later when our Lord comes. This is very significant too. You know, as religious people, we often think that we're trying to get to God, that it's our idea sometimes, but not at all. We find out in the gospel today that it's the Lord who's after us. He's the one coming to get us. In the monastery, we have bells, and in every monastery, bells are very important. And in the tradition, they're called, in the Latin, Vox Dei, the voice of God. They're not just nice sounds. They are God calling us. So when you hear the church bell ring, it's not just to say, well, there's going to be something going on at the church. It's God calling us to pray. Very good thing to remember. This is God's idea that we're here today. And somehow that bell has gone off in you from childhood, probably, to come and be with the Lord, because he's calling us. It's his idea that we be blessed by the one God who made us, loves us enough to die for us, and holds us in existence. That's the good news, and that's why we're here today. Now, St. Thomas, wonderful to remember this. Very important. St. Thomas does get sort of a bum rap. He is called the doubter, but he's not alone. Every one of those men who followed the Lord, and the women too, they doubted. In fact, they did not even expect Jesus to rise. He told them he would, but they did not expect it. Notice today, In fact, both these days that we celebrate, Easter and a week later, what are they doing? Out celebrating that the Lord has risen? No, they're locked up behind doors, afraid that the people who crucified their Savior, their Lord, would come and get them and do the same thing to them. They had no idea in their minds that the Lord was going to rise from the dead. They did not expect it. The women went to visit the tomb. The men did not. Thank you, ladies. We know that you hold up the church all the time. I know we've got a pope and the bishops and all that, not the apostles, but the women make things work. They showed up, but even they were showing up to anoint a dead body, not to welcome the risen Lord. They were showing up to see the dead body of someone they loved, but that's all. And then he rises and he walks into their life. We have all kinds of ways to avoid the Lord. Of course, the main thing is sin, when we turn away from the Lord Jesus. But does that stop him? No. He's after us. He wants us for our good. He wants us to know him and love him. And so he walks right through those locked doors, and he does that for us. No matter how much we can try and keep him out, he's going to walk through and show himself to us. And notice what he does when he walks into that locked room with those frightened men. He shows them his wounds. Isn't that chilling? He walks in and he says, "Look, this is what the world did to me." Now, you might think, like I would, I'm not God. I might walk in and appear first to Pontius Pilate, you know, and say, "Okay, it's payback time." Or I might appear to Caesar and said, "I won, and you're dead." No, he went to his unbelieving apostles, and he showed them what the world did to him, what the world does to God when he visits us. And then his response is to them, you heard it, "Peace be with you." Peace, this is what the world did. Now peace be with you. That's the love of God. If you'll notice, anytime the bishop comes to visit, he's echoing those words. At the beginning of Mass, when we priests would say, "The Lord be with you," and everybody responds, "And with your spirit," the bishop doesn't say, "The Lord be with you." He's like all the apostles ever since those first ones in that room locked behind those doors. They echo, the bishops, the successors to the apostles, they echo those same words. The bishop says, "Peace be with you." The words of the Lord Jesus to a world that killed him. You know, our Lord came to give us that peace. He came here to forgive us. That's the whole deal. He didn't come to congratulate us. He came to forgive us, to heal us. That's the good news of Easter. And he's done that for us already, even before we ask. But of course, we have to take it to heart and make it real in our life. He forgives the whole world. We just have to say yes to that great gift. And Easter calls us to do that very thing. We've got these 50 days to let that sink in and know that love of God. And if it does sink in, it changes everything. You know what it's like to have somebody in your life at some point who loves you. And you know what you're like in response to that. I've got one of those people in my life. And when I'm around that person, I'm amazed at myself at how good I can be. It's something else. How our life is changed by someone who loves us absolutely and completely. And when that lover is God Himself, our Lord Jesus, everything is changed. Everything is new. Lord Jesus, You are risen from the grave. Help us to hold tight to You and rise with You. Amen.
Amen.
If I might keep you just another moment to invite you to St. Bernard. Just a week from today and a week from yesterday, our big Bloomin' Festival is taking place at St. Bernard. That's the 22nd and 23rd of April. That'll be the third Sunday of Easter. And we're inviting you to come and be with us. Most of you know about the festival, and many have attended. And so please come. It's a way we have to celebrate what God does with 25 ordinary men. And we very much are it's a miracle, really. And it is something to celebrate. So please come and be with us at the Bloomin' Festival. God does wonderful things with us. And so we like to thank Him, and the festival is all about that. It's a great time of arts and crafts and food and music and entertainment, lots of fun. You'll have a good old time if you come. Both those days, Saturday and Sunday next weekend, from 9 until 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And as a part of the festival, of course, we have that great Catholic tradition, a raffle. And so I've littered your pews with the tickets, and there's a St. Bernard table out there that has a pile of them there as well, and you're welcome to take those tickets, and you may mail in a donation as you like, or leave it here. There's some envelopes there to mail in. But thank you for considering that. It helps us to do the great things that we do at St. Bernard. The first thing is, of course, our prayer, the most effective thing that monks do and that you do. So that huge part of the monastic life. And then, of course, we have our school. We have the retreat center where you're invited to come anytime and be with us and nurture your inner monk, you might say. And then we have also parish work that we occasionally will do. Two of our monks are pastors in parishes in this diocese. We also have a big cattle farm there at St. Bernard, about 900 acres of land, takes a lot of work. So the festival helps us with all of that. So thank you for considering the tickets. Now, there's not an absolute price for one of those tickets, because in our fair state of Alabama, that would be called gambling, and we don't gamble. However, the monks have a suggested offering, and that is $5 for one of those tickets, or $25 for a big sheet of six of them. And there's no limit to how many you can take, so consider that. Thank you. Most of all, try and be with us on one of those days, at least next weekend. Oh yes, and of course there are always prizes with the raffle. Now, I can't remember all of them, there are five of them, but the big one I do remember, and it's some sort of a Jeep. So you can look at the photograph of it on the St. Bernard table there. Most of all, thank you for your patience with me and for your love that you've shown over the years to St. Bernard. I especially bring you greetings from Father Marcus, now Abbot Marcus. You know, he got sentenced to that job a few years ago, a poor man. And he always remembers coming here to St. Peter's. This is a favorite place of his in the diocese. So he made sure that I'd tell Father Vernon and all of you hello and to come visit us at St. Bernard. God bless you all. Hope to see you next weekend. Thank you, Father.
Father Ray and I took Father Joel out to eat last night, and we were talking about the monastery and what it does. And the monks, the Benedictines in Coleman, have a good relationship with the diocesan priests in Birmingham. When the priests have their annual retreat, we go up to St. Bernard's and we have an awesome time. And on that Wednesday evening of priest retreat, we come together and we have hors d'oeuvres and we have a little libation and an awesome meal. When I first was ordained, I was on the retreat committee for refreshments. Now go figure that out. I had to bring refreshments for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday night. And on Wednesday night, I would make an extra attempt to get salmon and shrimp and all of this so they can have an awesome time. Well, we just resurrected a new retreat committee, and who's over refreshments again? Voila. So, but I told Father Ray last night, I said, when we retire, we need to go just live in the monastery, and all we have to do is say Mass and take people on tours around the monastery. Father Ray looked at me, and I said, no, I don't think we're going to do that. Thank you, Father Joel, for your inspirational homily and for your plug to come to the Blooming. And I must confess, I've never been to the Blooming Festival, but I must make it happen next year. I can't do it next week because I have to be with the Knights of Columbus next week, but I'm going to make it happen. But I'm always happy to have you as a friend in my home. Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried,
and rose again on the third day, in accordance of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds with the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We now turn to God to offer to him our prayers and our petitions.
Our response is, God of mercy, hear our prayer. That our Catholic Church and all Christian churches may give praise to God and be living signs of the saving power of the resurrection by our witness to faith and our charity for all who hurt. We pray to the Lord. God of mercy, hear our prayer. That the world's leaders may come to reject more and more hatred and violence and open new doors for the gift of peace, especially where the doors seem locked. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That those who suffered the distress of many trials, especially the trial of natural disasters, may soon be delivered from their affliction by a compassionate government and a compassionate citizenry. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That the witness of holiness may inspire the young to dare to commit themselves to the priesthood and the religious life, we pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That our servicemen and women and all first responders in harm's way may be blessed with safety, and that the seriously ill in our community and among our family members and friends be gifted with comfort, loving care, and the healing touch of God, we pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That those in mourning may be lifted up in hope by Easter's promise of life, especially Tommy Bostick and Bob Wiltsey, and all our parishioners, family members, and friends who have passed on, marked with the sign of faith, be born into an inheritance imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, we pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
On this Divine Mercy Sunday, that we as individuals and families will be open to recognizing and receiving the gift of mercy from Jesus and share it with others, we pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Joe Liberti. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
God of mercy, we come before you today, giving you thanks and praise for your many graces and blessings. Hear our prayers and grant them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
on my brother. Lord, have mercy on my sister. While I'm praying down on my knees, Lord, have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
Around a brother who is lying on a bed of pain. We're praying, Lord, won't you lift him up and take his burden away? So I'm praying,
Lord, have mercy on my brother.
Have mercy, oh Lord.
Lord, have mercy on my sister.
Have mercy, and while I'm praying down on my knees, Lord, have mercy on me. For the children caring for the parents, for a mother worrying about a child, we're praying, Lord, won't you lift them up and give them a peace for a while. I'm praying now,
Lord, have mercy on the children.
Have mercy, oh Lord.
Lord, have mercy on the parents.
Have mercy, and while I'm
praying for all of these, praying now, oh, oh Lord, please, Lord, have mercy.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Today is Divine Mercy Sunday. There will be a bilingual prayer service at 3 o'clock p.m. of the Divine Mercy Chaplet. So please attend at 3 o'clock. As I mentioned before, my 30th anniversary of priesthood is less than 2 months away. And that we're going to have the celebration on June the 11th, which is a Sunday. And the Mass will be at 3:30. As a priest, I have always thought outside of the box. Whenever I had special celebrations, I always did an extra different Mass from the stationary Mass time, because I've always think about people getting caught at a Mass that they don't want to be at, and that's a terrible thought. But having it at 3:30, the people that are coming are people that want to be there. My dear priest friend, Father Kevin Foss, he's a Vincentian priest in San Antonio, Holy Redeemer Church. He's going to be the preacher for the Mass. During my celebration, I never preach my own Mass, so he was here 2 years ago, and I think he presided and preached at the 8:30 and 11 o'clock Mass, and some of y'all deemed him the white version of Father Vernon Hughes, because we have the same mannerisms. He walks the aisle, and he gets right up on you, and he's bold. So Father Kevin will be coming, and I'm leery, but it's going to be good.
It's going to be good. I've been doing a lot of preparation, and I'm going to have a combined choir between St. Peter's Choir and the Diocesan Gospel Choir. So I just, and an announcement will be coming out within the next few weeks, and so you would have to RSVP so that we will know how many folk to feed. And it's going to be a Mardi Gras celebration party, so I'm already excited. I've got music going through my head and all of that kind of thing. I do hope you have a blessed day and a blessed week. I will see some of you during the week and the rest of you the following weekend. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Please join together in singing our recessional hymn, number 573, Let Heaven Rejoice, number 573.